A lot of very exciting stuff coming up very quickly. Metal Slug 3 is coming up very soon, as well as a slew of Contra games, including a two-man race in Contra for the NES. I just want to remind everyone real fast that, yes, we still do have the bonus Contra 3 The Alien Wars donation incentive, and it still needs to be met. So please, it is an awesome run, and we definitely want to see it happen. So for an any percent Death Warps run by Mr. K, let's go ahead and get that in. We have just a little under $12,000, and I know that we can do it before that time. Thank you so much for your generosity here. My name is Sudi, and I'm going to be turning things over to Lennon Free here. So hey, thank you all so very much. It's been a pleasure.
Hello out there, everybody. My name is Lennon Free, and thank you very much for watching AGDQ 2017. Coming up next, we have Metal Slug 3 from jackafur, which is one of my favorite games, so stay tuned. I think you'll enjoy it, too. Following that, we've got the Contra block coming up, and I'd like to mention that the bonus Contra 3 The Alien Wars has not quite been met. We've got $18,000 out of $30,000, so if you want to see that, this is probably the time to do it. And I hope you like glitches, because we've also met a couple donations incentives lately with the Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus glitch exhibition being met, so that will be coming up later, as well as the Grand Theft Auto Vice City glitch exhibition. That will also be in the near future. In the meantime, while they're setting up Metal Slug 3, I will be reading a couple donations for you. I have $50 from Jabba's Tuba Solo that says, I'm loving Super Star Wars, can't wait for Taskbot and Super Dram World. $50 from Cheese Bar says, love the tenacity of this event. My family has had bad cancer RNG, and anything we can do to help humanity high roll against this plague is great. You guys rule. $5 from Captain Snuggles that says, live music, bless your heart. That was an amazing song. I hope you guys caught that out there. And on the same vein, we have $50 from Anonymous that says, let him sing again. His voice is so calming. I also have a $20 donation from A12 Helton that says, here's hoping I can make it one of these years. Would love to meet those who have inspired me. We would absolutely love to have you. All right, now, just before we get into the Metal Slug 3 game over here, let's go to an interview with Fiesel. He will be interviewing the Mexican runner, Toad22484, and Mr. K.
I'm here with the runners from the Contra Block. We've got Mr. K, got the Mexican runner, and Toad. We're going to be seeing 3 or 4 Contra games coming up right after Metal Slug here. But first, I have to ask you guys, what do you think makes Contra so popular as a series for speedrunning? It just seems to be a lot of runners of all the Contra games, and you're also so tight-knit.
Well, I think what makes it like really interesting is how much that no matter how much you put into it, there's still more to get. Like the rhythm sections and the bass areas, they have a lot to give and a lot to get. You really have to put a lot of effort into that. And there's still a lot of good technique to it too, like setups for specific bosses and such.
I think like very deep, like it's like a dream for kids, like, you know, just running with a machine gun and, you know, killing the aliens. So it kind of fulfills something inside you, and it just makes it a great game. The music, Konami is a really good developer of games. Yeah, I think that is why it's so popular, too.
Yeah, that sounds right to me, yeah.
I think there's a definite nostalgia factor with definitely the first Contra, maybe less so with Super C, but also it's just a fun game to play. It's really punishing, but the game makes you get better, and once you get better, you do better, and that's just a really good feeling, and that's really satisfying in a speedrun.
They seem very accessible games, too. You know, even though quite a difficulty curve, still just like the kind of thing where it's just easy to pick it up and start playing without really having to understand much.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, in particular, I see a lot of co-op runs with Contra, just a lot of co-op runs. Why do you think that is? Why is it so popular for co-op speedrunning?
Well, I personally think it's just when you come to an event like AGDQ and have, like, the best players, like, it naturally... Normally you play the game solo, but like here's the opportunity to play co-op, and it just feels so good to, it's like a new modality of the game. It's a whole different game, you feel like speedrunning the game for a really long time, it just, it feels kind of monotonous, but you know, having the co-op, it's like you unlock a new mode, and it just makes you wanna go and go and go.
So I hear there is a new co-op Contra record that happened here at GDQ in the practice room.
Well, I thought it was a world record, but unfortunately, Still Mr. K. Mr. K and DK run is 1 second faster. I did with Angry Lanks a run that was 9:55. Theirs is 9:54, but we still have a few days. I hope that record gets beaten.
The real secret to co-op Contra speedrunning is to live close to the person you're speedrunning with. But I think that Contra is really meant to be played with two players. And when you have two people who are playing well and you have a stupid amount of firepower, it just makes the game really, really satisfying.
So speaking of Contra runners getting together, the Contra Conference is an event that's happened a number of times so far, and I guess the point of that is to get Contra players together to do co-op. Do you want to talk a little bit about how that got started and what goes on there?
Oh, gosh, that's a little obscure, but yeah. So a few years ago, I organized just at some of the different homes in our community what we called the Contra Conference, and the point of that was actually not to raise money, not to grow viewership. It was just we wanted to get the best possible two-player speedruns we could get for Contra games. And so that was the focus, and that's where the 954 came from, which is hanging on by a thread right now. But it's a blast, and it's really nice to see ways of speedrunning games that were not normally accessible become accessible when you can just sit down with someone and grind out runs and strats for like 10 hours, 12 hours, 14 hours a day.
Right, and you worked on all the Contra games, or as many of them as you guys could,
As many of them as we could. We try to leave out the PS1 Contras as much as we can.
Okay. All right. Which Contra record do you think is going to be the hardest to be broken at this point? Because I know there's a couple of these games have really optimized records. What do you think will be the hardest one for someone to go for?
I think easily DK's record in Contra, the first Contra, is the hardest, the 953.
That's a pretty amazing
one.
Yeah,
run. I'm pretty sure that's the best record on the NES period at this point. His ability to get rhythm in those bases is second to none, period.
What about Super C? What do you think is going to happen with that record?
I thought it was strong, but then like a month earlier, somebody found another 10-second save, and there's another 20-second save, just more stuff being found every day.
But that's good, though. It keeps people coming back to it, keeps people playing it, doesn't get stale.
I like that. When new tech is found for any game, it's really interesting to see what they can do with it, and it can sometimes lead to even more tech and more time coming on.
Well, we have a bonus game incentive for Contra 3 to be added. I think last I checked, it was like 11 or 12,000 away, but you have through the end of this this Contra block to start donating for it. But please do, if you want to see Contra 3 end up in this marathon, you know, please go ahead and put your money in for it. I mean, what do you guys think of Contra 3? Can you really sell us on the idea? What is it about that run that we want to see?
So this speed run is absolutely stupid. It actually lets you skip through stages. The only time anyone has ever skipped through a stage in Contra and Super C is because of a hardware error on the NES. It just doesn't happen. But Contra 3, you can skip entire stages, and it looks really silly, and it's really awesome. If it's done right, I'm going to be a little bit safe, but you can beat Contra 3 on hard mode in under 4 minutes. So it's the fastest Contra speedrun there is that finishes the game. Nice. I'll be going a little bit longer for that, but it's an amazing run. It's really silly, it's really stupid, and it looks absolutely ridiculous, and I love it. So you should donate for it.
All right, well, let's talk about some of the other games you guys have run or some of the things you've done over the years. Now, Mr. K, you're probably one of the longest-running Contra speedrunners that I can think of. Can you talk a little bit about your experience running Contra over the years and how the scene has changed since you started?
So I actually exclusively did Contra 3 and Contra 4. So I started speedrunning in about 2008. Obviously, getting a good speedrun has taken a lot longer than I thought.
Right.
but I had to take breaks now and again because, you know, I have a life. But it's been really great to see the kind of the community grow and change. So initially, there were only like one or two people working on a Contra game at a given time. So like, Heidman was working on like Super C and really Contra at the same time. And how many times do we have on speedrun.com for Contra now?
Around 70
or 80. Yeah.
The amount of work and dedication and eyes looking at the game has just grown exponentially, and it's really blown me away. And also, just people like to speedrun it for fun. Some people are like, I want to get like below 10 minutes and 30 seconds. Not necessarily world record.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It's growing really, it's getting really big, and I never thought that Contra games would be that popular to speedrun, and it's really good to see a new wave of people pick up the games.
Yeah, that is great. So TMR, you very famously took that Contra 1 record, and I remember that reaction was so entertaining. I don't know, do you want to talk a little bit about your attempts at that?
Because
went really hard at that game.
Definitely that game. First I started the game because in SRL people were doing races of that game, so I decided to join one, and I kind of liked it. The game, it was simple and nice. So I just keep going, and eventually my time was below 11 minutes. Eventually the sub 10:30 goal, like that was a holy grail back then, and I got it. And then I was like, well, I might have a chance for a world record. But you know, like in contra at the top level, you really need good mashing, and my mashing is really not the best. It's really average for the gaming point of view. And well, I was getting closer, and finally I got the run. And well, it's just I barely caught the run by 0.1 of a second, but that was enough like to claim a world record. And it was like really a moment that a lot of emotions came to me. So I just screamed the famous world record, guys, world record,
something like that.
Yeah, something like that. You know how it goes. Right. And yeah, and at the current time, I managed to get a sub 10 minutes. I was the third person in the world to do it, and that is a very ambitious goal. And yeah, now it's the holy grail, sub 10 minutes.
Cool.
Got 9:59, and yeah, I'm very happy with it.
All right, and Toad, you're a very prolific NES speedrunner. You've run a lot of different titles from a lot of different series. What attracted you to Contra specifically? I mean, because you could be running anything right now.
That's true. I lied even. No, I think the just difficulty in Contra overall to excel, to try to get that sub 10, like TMR was talking about, being the holy grail of Contra at this point, is the drive to do it is just endless. Like, you really want to put out a top time and kind of a top run game as well. Contra's become one of the more top run games on the NES, and I think it'd be an excellent benchmark to add my name to the greats of the sub 10s of Contra.
Great. Well, thank you guys for talking with us. I really hope that Contra 3 incentive gets met. Don't forget, it's not too late to donate. Mr. He really wants to play it as easy. Please.
It needs to happen. Please.
All right. But good luck with your block, guys. Thank you for talking with us today. Up next, we got Metal Slug 3 by jackafur. And then immediately after that, we've got Contra 1, 2, maybe 3, and 4. So stick around for that.
Foundation awarded 4 International Technology Transfer Fellowships to a group of Moldovan doctors to study at institutes in the UK and Italy. Upon their return, the doctors will educate their colleagues, incorporate the new knowledge into the state university's curriculum, and assist in establishing a gynecologic pathology center, in which pathologists and residents will be educated in the accurate diagnosis of cervical biopsies for the nationwide cervical screening program.
All right, I believe we're ready to cut to Metal Slug 3. Let me check that first. Are you guys out there ready for some Metal Slug 3? Yeah, I thought so. I figured as much. All right, well then let's go to jackafur for some killer games.
Hey.
I'm jackafur.
CSP.
You guys can introduce yourself.
You want
to? Overfiend. Might not be on camera.
I am just the Fend.
All right, sick. This is Metal Slug 3. I'm actually playing this on like actual arcade hardware. I have a consoleized version, basically. And yeah, are you guys? That's pretty much all I'm gonna say about that. All right, ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Normally, time starts like right now, but I didn't want to bug you guys with that. If I like don't talk. Or if I ignore people, it's just because I'm really focused. Okay. It's like really hard for me to talk and play this game at the same time. Usually I don't have issues with that, but for whatever reason, this game, it's a big issue for me for some reason.
Yeah, you'll notice that jackafur is playing on an arcade stick, and you know he's using the actual arcade hardware. We don't like ports here. We want the real stuff.
Exactly. I actually made this stick, too. Alright. Yeah, there's not a lot of tech. There's like zero tech in this game, by the way. It's all running and jumping and shooting. There is like some strategy and stuff. There's like a despawn trick, but that's really it. For the most part, I'm just going to be trying not to die.
Yeah, it's all skill. Jackafur's showing that he's really good at this game. What do you think about that, CFB?
I think this game is extremely difficult, and anyone that beats it live on a marathon is a really good gamer.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
We'll see what happens.
I'm glad you didn't die into any crabs.
Yeah, we didn't die into the first crab in the game, which is I really thought would happen. Now we're going to fight a big crab. Oh, this thing, so the game is called Metal Slug. These, like, tanks, anything that's, like, a vehicle is an actual Metal Slug. So if you hear me use the term Metal Slug or a term called slug crashing, that's what I'm talking about. You can crash the slugs on purpose. So, like, right here, you press A and B at the same time. And everyone knows that if you can press two buttons at the same time, you're a god gamer. So it's basically frame perfect, I heard.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. He's not dead yet. Okay, he died. That's good.
Good job.
That was almost bad. So Mission 2 is cool. There's, like, zombies and stuff. I might be kind of quiet here because I don't want to... You can turn into a zombie, which I will do later. It doesn't count as a death. You can actually, like, get out of the zombie form before losing a credit, which I'll use later.
Yeah, I always thought Metal Slug was, like, very unique with its really unusual enemies.
Yeah. All the zombie attack animations are really well animated, too.
Oh, that's not good.
Best weapon in the game?
Yeah, flame shot's really good. I was trying to set that up there so I don't accidentally get heavy machine gun. It makes it a lot worse. So this boss coming up, I'm going to purposely turn into a zombie because you get a really nice, like a really powerful attack. And this trick isn't too hard, but it's pretty easy to mess up, but hopefully he just gives me... I've been getting the good pattern in the practice room this whole week, so he probably won't give me that. Yeah, this isn't a good pattern. It's not the worst pattern, though, so that's good. All right, we got it. Then you can just sit here and it's pretty good. Thank you.
I'm glad you pushed the button, man.
Dude, I pushed the buttons. I was worried I'd miss that in the run, but...
Thank you for clapping for that.
Thank you for clapping.
How does that make you feel over feeding the strat? That's very easy and saves time.
Yeah. It's not super easy. Come on, man. It's easy to die there. Everything is easy, but it's easy to die too, which is bad. So this hardware actually came out like in 1990, and this game actually came out in the year 2000. So it came out really late in the lifetime of the system or whatever. And this game like really pushes the hardware to its limits. So I've seen this on every card I've played and every system where there's like some graphical glitches on this stage. There's some horizontal like garbage you'll see probably. As far as I know, it's pretty normal, so. You can see a little bit right there in the top right corner, but it gets a little worse. I accidentally threw four grenades, but I'm glad I did, actually. Oh, fun fact, I speedrun two games where you ride an ostrich. I don't know how that happened. The other game is Mischief Makers.
Dude, this ostrich owns.
I know, dude. It's the best.
This robot does not seem to be having a good time.
No.
Yeah, I almost died a few times, but it's all good.
Dude, you saved the president.
I saved the president, everyone. Although, it says CEO president, I think, so I don't think he's like the president of the states or anything, but this is a camel. He's also a metal slug. Thank you. Rocket launcher. Oh, thanks. Oh, we got the Hadouken guy. He's cool. I almost died again.
Living on the edge.
Yeah, dude. Like, really. It was a little close.
Is Capcom okay with this guy throwing Hadoukens?
maybe.
SNK and Capcom like to trade blows.
Yeah.
Might just be a good time to get a donation or two in.
Oh, yeah, sure, go ahead.
Sure. I got $25 from Caps that says, awesome metal slug run, not sluggish at all. Keep up the awesome work. I also have $25 from Yodax that says, please make Mayor K's Contra 3 run happen. The world needs to see how to skip stages. By the way, that is almost at $20,000 out of $30,000, so keep up donations for that coming.
Alright, so this boss, I call him Fantoon. He likes to ruin runs. If I'm going to die a lot anywhere, it's going to be here. Because he has this one attack pattern that's like, it's gold and it shoots, it's like a, I don't even know how to describe it right now. Sunrise Surprise is a good one.
Yo.
That's pretty good luck. Okay, he's doing his red attack, though. I was in a really bad spot for the red attack, but it's okay. Okay, this is the attack pattern I hate. Sometimes, yeah, there's nothing you can, yeah. Sometimes the projectiles spawn really low, and it's really hard to dodge. And I lost laser, so that sucks. The dog pattern is the pattern you want. Ghost dogs. At least he's giving us some ghost dogs again. Alright, not too bad. I'll take one death there, it's fine. Alright, so the next stage is Mission 5. It's actually the last stage in the game, but we're not even like halfway through the run yet. It's like a... What's that? Oh, no spoilers. Okay, I'm sorry. You didn't hear any of that.
Hear any of what?
I don't know, man. What were we talking about?
I don't know.
Word. All right.
You didn't. You didn't want that cool helicopter.
Yeah.
Just gonna take the Harrier instead.
Oh, so you're gonna see me like slug crash the jet and the helicopter a few times, and that's because I want to get grenades or bombs, like on the character herself and not on the vehicle, because you don't share bombs or whatever. Hopefully that makes sense. So the idea is I want to get out of this vehicle so I can collect bombs on Fio.
I don't think we really talked about your character selection. You want to talk about why you picked her?
Fio's the best, that's why.
There you go.
That's no other, you know. So you'll see me, I'll get in this helicopter and I'll get right out of it in a couple of seconds, because there's going to be an enemy that drops bombs.
When you're in the airborne vehicles, does it increase the health of enemies like the tank?
That's a good question. I'm not sure. It does that with the mechas on the... You know the brain mechas?
Yeah.
When you're in the tank, it does that. I don't know about the helicopter. That's a good question.
Thanks.
Yeah, no problem. All right. That was a little sketchy, but I like made that just in time. I'm gonna get bombs here too. There's a trick here. Hopefully I can get it. You kind of like go into the plane's hitbox. It's not a big... Oh man, whatever. Anyway, if I miss it, it's not a big deal, but it's just nice. Makes things a little easier. By the way, Peaches is a mini boss in this game. I stole that joke. I forget who. Oh, whoops. I'm gonna die, dude. I'm just gonna get out of this thing now. Normally, I wouldn't use bombs here, but it's okay. I only use a handful. Alright, see you later, Peaches. Speaking of Peaches, I think this is the first time he hasn't been on my couch for one of my runs. But. At least he's here in the game with us, dude. Okay. This TV like cuts off the edge a little bit, so I'm kind of being careful. I can't really see as much as I usually can on the right side, so.
I know that jackafur has like one of the best TVs to play video games on.
Yeah, I have a PVM, a Sony PVM. Some of you probably might know what that is. It's like a, I don't even know. It's a nice.
It makes me jealous.
All right, so this guy should almost be dead. I got kind of scared there. I thought I was going to die, but. I want to keep some grenades for later, but I kind of used a little too many. All right, cool. At least I didn't lose 30 grenades.
Dude, you beat the boss.
I beat the boss.
Good job. Save the world.
If this was Metal Slug 1, the game would be over, but. So we're getting kidnapped by an alien.
It's time for the best part of the game, dude.
Yeah. If you want to read donations, it's We got a little bit more auto scroller, so if you want to, go ahead.
I play this game. I know that we got some time.
Oh, word,
Eric. Yeah. I thought the Contra block was next, not Galaga.
Yeah, pretty much.
So here's $100 from Mikey P that says, donating for a great cause. My grandfather and uncle both lost their fights to cancer, but my father and his girlfriend's mother are both cancer survivors. Happy to donate to the Prevent Cancer Foundation. Putting this towards Contra 3, and remember, be nice, save the animals. I have $200 from David that says, donating for my mother who beat breast cancer 2 years ago and my uncle who lost his battle with cancer 3 months ago. Thanks for putting on these great events year after year. I have $50 from Mist189 that says, it's Friday and Metal Slug's getting run. I think it's time for a donation. Many thanks to all the runners for an awesome week. I have $75 from Anonymous that says, save the hostages, save ostriches, save the animals.
Nice donation, dude. Except for the part where you want to save the animals. It's pretty lame. But
word.
A plus otherwise. Yes.
I have $20 from CyberbotX that says, Contra hype. Good luck to Jackafur with Metal Slug 3 as well as the Contra runners. Since it hasn't been met yet, got to get that Contra 3 in.
If any of you guys haven't seen a Contra 3 run, it's pretty sick. I think JD can attest to that.
Okay. Yes.
Are you going to attest to that? Or
yes.
Just make me look like an idiot. It's okay.
Well, we're a little over $20,000 for that right now, so we got a little less than $10,000 to go and 3 games to do it in after this one. So we're well on the way.
All I can say is that Mr. K is the man, and you want to see more Contra from him.
Well, here's $20 from Bonesaw557. Oh. It says, yo, Jack, when's co-op? Sending everyone both in person and at the event and in the chat my love from Japan. This one is definitely one of the best GDQs so far. Keep up the great work, everyone. So, Jack, be a god gamer, and don't slug crash. Love you, man.
I love you too, man. So, Bonesaw is pretty much the reason I started playing this game again. We did actually start co-oping it, and we had some syncing issues, and we couldn't really do it. But it was fun while it lasted. But yeah, and I just kind of stuck with it after that. I also have done co-op runs with a guy named Tsukimos. He's a Korean guy. Oh, he's a kid. He's like 17, but he's cool. He has a really good time. He's got like a 25. And we did a co-op run that was a 28-minute co-op run. It was really fun. So shout-outs to him. He also helped me a lot with practice and stuff, so...
I have $20.01 from XCycleNL that says, just start running Donkey Kong as well, and then you'll be running 3 ostrich riding games. GG on the run and GG on the event so far.
What was the game? I'm really curious.
Donkey Kong.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah.
I don't think you'd get mad at jump rolls at all, though.
Yeah.
Zen Master over here.
I got $100 from Anonymous that says, we need to make that Contra 3 run happen. I have $75 from Stooge that says, I love you all. Good luck to all the runners and staff, and thanks for putting together another awesome Games Done Quick. SGDQ can't come soon enough. Have fun, everybody, and here's hoping to breaking last year's record.
Laser gun lags a lot here on like real hardware, but it's whatever. It's not too bad. I usually kind of try to avoid it, but...
I have $35 from Anonymous that says, thank you for doing what you do. Not only are you collecting money for a good cause, but raising awareness is important too. Thanks for this annual fun event. Greetings from Austria, not Australia. I have $75 from 52 cards, it says. Figured this many hours of entertainment is worth $75, even if it wasn't also for a good cause. And it's not 100% without the animals.
It's not true.
I think the game says otherwise, doesn't it?
Agreed. Word.
$20 from Chris Vane that says, hi, and good job to all the runners. Can't wait for that Contra block. Just love Contra 3. $50 from Bramari that says, another great GDQ this year for a great cause. Thanks to everyone involved. Hope to see that Contra 3 run. There seems to be a common theme around here.
Yeah.
$100 from JDB that says, a small donation during a block of my favorite games to my grandma and her fight years ago, my aunt who I lost a few years ago, to the scare my other aunt had last year, and becoming 50% less nutty after my own run in. Put it towards that Contra 3 run. Skip that setup block.
All right, I actually despawned an enemy there. I usually don't get it, so that was pretty cool. Yeah, you can clap. Just clap. It's fine. There's a lot of despawning here, too. Usually there's like a ton of these little Mars people that come out of here, but...
Can we clap for those?
Yeah. Go ahead. We despawned them. Thank you for asking, Overfiend.
You're welcome. Sorry.
No, it's fine. All right. There's another little skip coming up. Hopefully I get it. We're going to despawn this giant War of the Worlds thing, or whatever that book is called, I forget. Is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's the thing.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
All right, I like Enemy Chaser here too, so that's good. Makes things a little easier. All right. We didn't even see his, so good. He's gone. You'll see what it looks like in a second. The thing we skipped. This is a brain mecha. Okay. This thing. I gotta be careful here. You can kill. I killed this thing way too fast yesterday, and like it fell on me. It was not fun. So I gotta take my time. There we go. I knew it. The lag messed me up. I wasn't sure if I could go or not, and I couldn't. It's all right. It's whatever. Normally, I wouldn't die there, but...
If you filled your grenades, it's okay.
Yeah, that was on purpose, so I could get more grenades. I might die here, too, actually, because I don't have a weapon to kill these clones, so I just jump and hope for the best, basically, but we made it, so we're good. Okay.
And he's actually hopping out of the Metal Slug when he knows Brain Mechas are going to appear, because if he's in the tank, they have way more health.
Yeah, and then you jump back in after this one, and it's... Oh, almost died. It's because then the next Brain Mecha after this one will set it up so that this one drops health for the tank. If you don't, he'll drop, like, Enemy Chaser or something. Oh, you know what? I was just about to say I shouldn't be here because I don't want Flame Shot, and I got Flame Shot. So I had Super Shotgun, which was what I wanted, and then I forgot that clone drops Flame Shot. It's okay, though. I'll just lose a little bit of time. Ideally, you get Shotgun, and it goes really fast, and it's luck if you get Shotgun, and I got it, but then I picked up Flame Shot, so. Oh, well. All right, and we got Heavy Machine Gun a little too fast there, but it's okay. So this might take a little bit of time, a little extra time than normally would for me. When that flame shot came out, the green flame shot that enemy shot at me, if I had been facing to the right, I would have died. But for some reason, when you face to the left, it's good. I think. I might be making that up. But I think if you face to the left, it's good, but to the right is not.
I believe you.
Yeah. You don't breathe it in.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. You don't want to breathe in hot fire, man.
Yeah. That's the way it kills you, not the heat. What the heck? They're using the attack you used earlier against you.
They definitely are. Oh, I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, here we go. Okay. I always wait for this one. And then I go. Yo, it never happens, but sometimes on the left, one of those clones will come out and, like, puke blood at you. It didn't happen, thankfully, but, like, it happens, like, once a blue moon, and it catches you off guard, like, really bad. I thought for sure it was gonna happen, but it didn't. Okay. Alright, this guy's gonna drop shot, and we don't want that, so we're gonna be careful. Alright. I've lost a couple of runs to that before. All right, so time comes when we got like a minute or two, but basically when the boss's brains explode. But I'll let you know.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Have fun.
Dropped a crab. Not good. Heavy machine gun is okay. I'm being a little cautious. I'll explain why later, maybe, hopefully. All Okay, I lost a tank. That's not good. And I don't have drops, so.
Ah.
All right, so I was trying to... If I hadn't died there, I would have won CC, which means one credit clear. But I died, so we used a continue. It was close. We got close. I mean, this game is really hard. And in a marathon, it's a little scary, so... I'm not too upset. Plus, these drops really suck. I don't know. Heavy machine gun's not too hot here. And crabs aren't very hot either. Yeah.
I usually ban crabs from my chat, so.
Yeah, that's a good thing to do. And we got literal poo. All right, sick. Almost one CC. Yeah, oh, time, by the way.
Yeah, we dropped a flame shot.
Yeah, right at the end. Thank you. So, if that lag hadn't messed me up on that one boss, because he's pretty easy not to die to, it would have been 1cc. We'll just say it was 1cc.
Yeah.
That's fine.
That's what I saw.
You did it, man.
Yeah, it was 1cc. Mission all over, dude. One continue. I have beaten this game without dying before. It doesn't happen very... I actually got my 7th no miss yesterday, so that was cool. But that's it. Thank you for watching, and everyone, and everyone out there, too. Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks to Jackafur for that amazing Metal Slug 3 run. Coming up next is the start of the Contra block, which means that time is starting to run out to make that Contra 3 bid in the Contra 3 bonus run coming up. We're at 21,000 out of 30,000, and you got 3 Contra games to do it. So let's see if we can get those donations in and make that incentive in time. I have $25 from Anonymous that says, you guys running Metal Slug 3 are amazing, and I've got to pitch in some for Contra 3. Heavy machine gun. $20 from Brian and Owen that says, I used to own a Neo Geo home console with Metal Slug 3. I spent months trying to get a one credit run of the game, and I never quite got it. Much respect to the runner for making it look much easier than it is. And I can attest to that. That game is a lot harder than he made it look. $75 from IOPRED that says, let's kill cancer with a rocket launcher. Also, let's play some Contra 3 while we're at it. I have $10 from Anonymous that simply says,